Welcome back to the Rhode Show this morning in the buzz. Yesterday marked the one-year anniversary of the royal wedding, when the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge said their vows in the wedding watched by hundreds of millions around the world. The couple had a low-key anniversary spent at home yesterday, and although the wedding has come and gone, we are still seeing its influence. It's being called the Kate Middleton effect. Many brides are stealing the extravagant style for their own big day. Editor of the wedding website, TheKnot.com, says they're now seeing a lot of lace sleeves and ball gowns, as well as more traditional touches like flower girls and white bouquets. You guys are going to have to help me out with this one.
Of course there was this huge uproar when everything was going on, but I think, you know, in addition to incorporating maybe a little more lace, maybe we're seeing that traditional look. Mm-hmm. I think everyone was head over heels over Pippa's dress.
I was going to say, yes. What about Pippa?
From that, mm-hmm. And I know websites were selling out of that mm-hmm. dress. The designer was, you know, they were trying to make them as quickly as they were being ordered. That alone mm-hmm. was a trend in itself. That nice draping in the back, a simple white gown. I mean, who would have thought wearing white on someone else's wedding day?
I know,
but apparently
okay.
That's the tradition there. So.
They said she may have overshadowed her own sister.
I think
sister.
She did. Yeah? She did a little bit, sadly.
When she got out of that car, everybody's like, whoa.
She looked beautiful, though. So, yeah,
I've been out recently wedding dress shopping with a bunch of my friends. You know, mm-hmm. it's just the season for it. And another one of the things that I'm noticing is actually the veils. Because I know for myself, mm-hmm. I just had a little veil that I had up top, but it didn't even go to my shoulders. And it was a little birdcage veil, which mm-hmm. was pretty big. And now girls are starting to have a bit more of the traditional veil. And I'm wondering if that's thanks to Kate.
And so many celebrities influence mm-hmm. weddings all the time.
Oh, yeah.
All the time. I mean, they're looking through People magazine or any of these mm-hmm. other magazines, and they're bringing it to their stylist and saying, this is what I want to look like.
Oh, absolutely. And look at Kim Kardashian's wedding. I mean, so many mm-hmm. weddings are now televised.
Yes.
The royal wedding was done differently, of course, because it was just capturing the actual moments, whereas now you're seeing these reality spins mm-hmm. on weddings and shows like that. So, yeah, of course you're going to start seeing trends, and now they're trying to outdo one another of who can have the most stuff or the most guests or the most media coverage on that as well.
And let's just make sure the Kim Kardashian effect, the wedding
doesn't,
the most
divorces.
Then, you know, if you want to go with the dress look, that's fine. Just don't let it go 73 or 72 mm-hmm. days and then there. Yep. That's where the influence
and
can
you
end.
Know what else you're seeing too from certain celebrities is the dress change. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. For so long it was you have one dress and that's it. That is your big budget item. But now they're buying two, three dresses.
Yep. Yeah.
And to me, that's a waste of so much time. Your wedding is, you're busy enough. You're running around. Mm-hmm. You're saying hi to all your relatives. It's going to come and go very quickly. And you're going to spend half of your time, changing your hair, getting into a new dress. To me, that seems a bit silly.
You're going to look back and go, what happened? What happened to it? You know, I mean, you really are. You're going to look back a few years later and go, I don't remember a thing, about it.
Doesn't
it goes by so quick.
I know I changed my shoes. I was wearing, nice shoes for the ceremony, and then I threw on my sneakers. My husband, actually, they were wearing tuxes, but underneath they were wearing tuxedo t-shirts. So,
got
at night, and they just got comfortable. The ladies, they switch into flip-flops. Mm-hmm. I think you're right. Switching into a whole new gown, I mean, it takes a long time to get into those gowns for the first
place. A lot of
place.
Hands, too. The ones that lace up the back, and you got to get someone pulling from one way and zipping somewhere else.
Yeah.
I'm
going to take your word for it.
Another trend I'm finding, people being just like celebrities is they always take, these videos, just like, coming down the aisle, doing it to music videos, and I'm thinking everyone wants now their little bit of fame, even if it's YouTube fame, they're trying to make a big presence online.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I know, how many couples do you see that have start off with that traditional slow dance and mm-hmm. then just bust a move on the dance floor. They have some choreographed thing that they've created.
It's a big day for so many people.
It is.
It really
and they
is,
want to make it memorable.
They want to make it special.
Of mm-hmm. course.
So we threw up on Facebook to see, what you guys thought about the royal wedding trends. And I had a response on Twitter from Beth Hashway. She said the royal wedding really stood out to her.
Stood out to a lot of people, for sure. All mm-hmm. those fascinators.
Amen.